sleeping, you can play Dom Team Death, the free-for-all, CTF and sabotage. Man, I play them all from search up to headquarters, down the list of demolition. Objective is speaking, to win is my only mission. If I sin, it's not by omission of offering my...
Hey YouTubers, Hardcore Gamer for Life here, and the video you're watching right now is not going to be about the gameplay. Instead, I've had a topic that has sort of been in the back of my mind for a while without my realizing it, and I wanted to get it articulated, so that's what I'm going to do in this commentary. Also, my man QuakeBeats just did a commentary on a related topic himself, namely that we as a community don't appreciate the game anymore, and so I thought I'd post a response to it and add my two cents to the topic, as well as saying congratulations to QuakeBeats, as he is now finally a Machinima director. Way to go, man. Now, to start off with, I'm going to begin by saying I've been in this YouTube game for some time now, much longer than many Machinima directors in the tens of thousands range, and even a few in the hundreds of thousands of subs, so while this is completely my opinion, and I could be wrong on any or all of it, you're not hearing it from someone who just fell off the turnip truck. I've been here in the community for over 3 years now, and over two of that as a content creator, which, while it may not seem like a lot, it's nearly the entire lifespan so far of this YouTube Call of Duty community. Now, between 2 and 3 years ago, this community really started kicking into high gear. Towards the end of World at War and continuing into the beginning of Modern Warfare 2, it saw a huge boom in viewership, which was subsequently followed by a commensurate boom in commentators, montage makers, etc. This was like the gold rush of the Call of Duty community. Everyone and their brother was starting to realize, hey, this is a largely unpenetrated market and it seems like there's a lot of demand for it. And at that point, basically any newcomer who was even decent and consistent at what they were doing started to see at least some limited success. At that point, it was still a ground floor opportunity. However, it didn't take long for the honeymoon to end and signs of strain to begin creeping into the community. Towards the end of Modern Warfare 2, in fact, people in the community started to bitch about the game very vehemently and in large numbers. Commando, noob tubes, care package and javelin glitches, boosters. Not that there weren't always people who bitched about the game, but it started to become more and more widespread and with an ever more serious tone to it. It was more like lulls in the beginning, but as Modern Warfare 2 stretched into Black Ops, you started to hear the community complaining more and more. And if you take an honest look at Black Ops and Modern Warfare 2 side by side, you have to admit, Black Ops has less BS and issues. Aside from things like second chance and RC cars, ghost campers, the main complaint against Black Ops was its slow pace, yet more and more people jumped on the negativity train at this time. Fast forward to Modern Warfare 3. It literally takes only weeks for virtually the entire community to jump on the hate train for this game. And why? Does it have commando lunges, unlimited overpowered noob tubes with danger close, and are they still not banning cheaters like in Modern Warfare 2? No. None of these issues exist any longer. Is it still painfully slow-paced like Black Ops was? Again, no. They were aiming for a more fast-paced game, and I think even its most outspoken critics would have to admit this is the fastest-paced Call of Duty yet. Also, realize the studio who made Modern Warfare 3 was really only Infinity Ward in name. The two heads of the studio, plus many of the lead programmers, left to form Respawn Entertainment. They didn't just bring Sledgehammer and Raven in for kicks. They were critically short-staffed, with most of the project leaders having taken a walk, and working with two other companies who they'd never worked with previously. And considering all that, I think they turned out a great product in this game, and more importantly, with the large number of patches, hotfix, and playlist updates so far, have implemented a great support strategy as well. So, what is it that makes Modern Warfare 3 so widely criticized in the community? Mainly just three things as far as I can tell. Spawns, lag compensation, and death streaks. There are other complaints here or there, but those are the big ones. I personally don't think death streaks are as bad as they're cracked up to be. I definitely agree we could do without Final Stand and especially Dead Man's Hand, but I don't feel they're game ruiners for me. Now, spawns have always been an issue in every Call of Duty from World at War on. That's nothing new, although admittedly Modern Warfare 3 is the worst so far. And lag, you know, it's always an issue in online gaming. The internet itself is laggy. They tried to do something with the coding of this game to address that, namely lag compensation, and although it can't be argued that they haven't hit the mark yet on that one, I feel they deserve some credit for even trying, and they're continually doing playlist updates to try and get it optimized. My point is, I don't think the real problem is so much with the game as it is with the commentary community at large. Many of the larger commentators, you can just tell they've gotten burned out on Call of Duty, and many are looking for something fresh and new while still others continue to play the game despite bitching about it in most or all of their commentaries. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not suggesting that these games are beyond reproach, and I do agree, it's our duty as commentators and content creators to let the shortcomings of the game be known, otherwise they might not get enough exposure for the developers to consider them worth fixing, but at the same time, I feel it would be really helpful to the whole process if we, as a community, just eased it up a bit on the negativity. As XJaws demonstrated earlier this month, we'll get a lot farther with respectful and well-thought-out criticism than we will by raging at this stuff. One of the first commentators to really begin complaining about the game in a big way was Blame Truth. At the time, I just thought, man, I don't sub to you to hear constant bitching about the game. If you don't like it, then don't play it. I actually unsubbed to him because I was just tired of hearing complaining every commentary. Sometime later, I happened to cross one of his videos, and he had actually stopped playing Call of Duty altogether and was now playing stuff he enjoyed more. Even though much of it wasn't my cup of tea, I resubbed, just for the simple fact that he had decided to do what he enjoyed rather than playing a game he hated just because he knew it would get him more views. Now move ahead to Modern Warfare 3 and your boy Wings of Redemption, along with some other commentators previously considered really strong players, are humbled to some lesser or greater degree by this game. Blame it on the lag compensation or things like Akimbo FMG9s and Type 95s, but some commentators who previously had no problems getting great gameplays on a regular basis began to struggle to do so in Modern Warfare 3. Take Wings, for example. Now, I have been and continue to be a huge fan, both literally and figuratively, of Wings of Redemption, so don't get me wrong, I got nothing but love for him. And I can tell you with complete certainty that were it not for him, I would not be sitting here doing this commentary right now. When he gets in his element doing his gameplay breakdowns especially, but even in the great majority of his random commentaries, there's not a more natural one-take man on all of YouTube as far as gameplay commentaries go, in my opinion. But lately he's been struggling with being burned out on Modern Warfare 3 in particular, and Call of Duty in general, and his channel, despite his continuing to post just as regularly, and despite it continually growing subscriber base, is nonetheless declining in views. And for someone like Wings, who actually lives off the money he makes from his channel, this is a major concern. And I don't blame him for continuing to post Call of Duty, even though he really isn't enjoying it anymore. The simple fact of the matter is, nothing in the video game world, with the possible exception of Minecraft, will get you the kind of views Call of Duty videos will. And like myself, Wings is not a fan of Minecraft, so why go from one game you don't really enjoy much anymore to another you never enjoyed in the first place just for the sake of views? Doesn't make sense. But basically what Modern Warfare 3 has done, at least in his case, and doubtless in many others, is given him a dose of humility. And this isn't me putting words in anyone's mouth, this is stuff he's straight up said in his commentaries. And forgive me if this is an unpopular opinion, but I think a nice dose of humility is just what the Call of Duty YouTube community needs right about now. So many people have spent so long hiding behind keyboards, monitors, gamer tags, and controllers that it seems like the desire to have an intelligent and lively debate and exchange of information in this community is being sublimated by idiots and e-penis measuring contests. Everyone wants to act like they eat nails for breakfast and shit bullets in the evening time, have a 10KD and never go on a death streak, when the reality is we're all human and even the best of us have a bad game sometimes. I guess overall what I'm driving at here is that it seems like it's time for the community to evolve or die. There are a growing number of adults coming into the community, as well as quite a few younger folk as well, both as content creators and viewers who can find it within themselves to be sensible, respectful members of this community and make it a more thoughtful and reasonable forum for us to voice our ideas and opinions than it currently is. I think a lot of people are getting sick of the rampant negativity in the community, and if so, we can either be part of the solution or part of the problem. So if we want to be part of the solution, then we need to be more intelligent and thought-provoking, both as content creators and feedback providers, and less negative and jaded. If Call of Duty gets too old hat for us to enjoy as a community any longer at some point in the near future, we need to be flexible enough to move on to Respawn Entertainment's new upcoming game, or whatever it is that becomes the next big thing in FPS gaming. Regardless, we have to focus on what we're doing in the here and now, and continually bitching in a non-constructive fashion and labeling it entertainment is just not cutting it. This is a shout out to all commentators and viewers, the whole community. Let's make this community great again. One original idea, one video, one tweet, one comment or rating at a time. This has been Hardcore Gamer for Life. Thanks for viewing, and in conclusion,
all I want to know is who's coming with me? Who's coming, man? Who's coming with me? Eh?